guys, this is Tash. How are you going? I'm Tash the Starcross Stitcher. Welcome to my 8th, I think, episode of Floss Tube. I am in my pajamas this morning. I just woke up. It's like 7:30. Oh, it's probably 8 o'clock now in the morning. Tim's still in bed and I didn't want to go in there and shower, put on a bra and everything, so it would have woken him up. So I'm coming to you in my pajamas. I'm sorry about that. If you don't like it, all complaints can be sent to tash@idontcare.com. Alright, let's talk about stitching, because I've got some good things to show you. So, I finished a big one. A big one. Ta-da! Wow! Oh my god, guys, I'm so proud of this. I can't believe it. I'm so proud of it. This is Firefly Fairies by Lavender and Lace. And it's finished. This thing has a lot of crinic. It has 1,010 beads. I started this in 2004, I think. Somewhere around there. Somewhere between 2002 and 2005, let's just say that. So I'll call it 2004. So this is 13 years of progress, which is entirely unnecessary. There's no way it needed to take me that long, but there were a lot of years in there when I didn't stitch at all, a lot of years when I didn't touch it. I started tracking the hours when I'd finished the whole green fairy, I'd finished all of the cotton on the pink fairy, I'd put all the crinic on the green fairy, and on this big thing, star. But I hadn't done any of the blue fairy, any of the beads, or any of the crinic on the bottom half of the chart. So I'm calling that the halfway point. So I started tracking halfway through, which was at February this year, and since February I've done 76 or 78 hours of work. So I am pretty sure that this is around 150 hours of work for me, because I'm very slow. There's no reason it needs to be 150 hours for most people, maybe. But yeah, for me, 150 hours of work over 13 years, I'm very proud of it. I made a little video with some close-up shots that I will put in here. Ta-da! Here they are, the beautiful fairies. I finished this. Today is Saturday morning and I finished them really late on Thursday night. They've got so much bling, so much crinic, so many beads. I just thought I'd give you a little quick video to see if you can see how many beads there are in this. The stitches aren't perfect in all places, of course. See the faded crinic up there? All the silver crinic is really faded. All these dark silvery ones in here. And when I come down here, you'll be able to see the difference. See here, this is the unfaded crinic around this star, and that's the faded. It's not faded, it's like rusted or something. It's very weird. But there they are. There's so much detail in their dresses. It's so sweet. Don't look at my stitches there. For some reason, I don't like my light-coloured stitches. They're little petticoats. Maybe it's the coverage. Those stitches just would not sit right. Same over here. These ones just look terrible. But on their dresses, it's fine. So yeah, there we go. There's the Firefly Fairies. I thought you'd like a little close-up picture, so you could see just how encrusted with bling they are. Okay, see you in the rest of the video. So, yeah, I don't know if you guys can see in that video how encrusted with bling it is. It's like almost heavy. It's only got half as much beads as Jessie Marie's Persephone, or her Frosty Knot Garden. So it's probably not as heavy as hers is. Not that I'm comparing my work to Jessie Marie's. I love her. I love her Frosty Knot Garden and her Persephone. I want to do Persephone because she has inspired me and enabled me. So yeah, I'm very proud of this finish. I'm very proud of this finish. The fabric was bleached by me, following the instructions in the chart. Actually didn't quite follow the instructions. We got a spray bottle, my mum and I, and we filled it up with bleach and water and like mixed it all up. Then we just laid out the fabric and like sprayed all over it. And so obviously the like drips came off the bottle and fell on the fabric. Yeah, I'm actually not that happy with the fabric, but at this point I'm certainly not changing it. So I'm going to try and frame it with as much of the starburst as possible showing, like that. Just fall over a little bit at the top and then a little bit at the sides. I think it's quite pretty. So this is going in my niece's room. My niece Charlotte, she's 5 years old. She's just moved into a new house. She's got a nice new room. She's got lots of pretty things in her room. And I think she'll really like this. It'll be lovely in there. So yeah, she'll like it. I don't... So here's the weird thing about this. I actually don't even like this anymore, really. You know, you spend... You pick something up... So I was 20, maybe, when I started this, and I think I started it because I saw a model in a shop in Sydney called Morris & Sons, and I liked it, and I just decided at some point that I was going to do it. This was going to be the thing I did. And at the time, it was like a gigantic thing. It was really kind of intimidating and scary, and... So I picked it up, I started it, I hated it, I put it down. And I kind of have fallen out of love with it. Like, it is very pretty, it's just the subject matter isn't something I'm into anymore. Fairies and big buffy dresses and whatever. And I kind of finished it just because I wanted it, out of my life. But Charlie will really like it. Charlie will love it. And I'm happy to finish something for her, so that's good. I'm just glad it's on, you guys. So, excuse me. I'm in your face, I know that. So, in celebration of getting it done, just a minute. Sorry, I can't have that. It's not laying straight. Okay. In celebration of having that done, I would like to give away the chart. There's the chart. Firefly Fairies, it's here. It's all in here. It's all original. The chart itself is actually, like, in... Why is it so... I'm in front of the window. There you go. That's better. Chart itself is in like perfect condition because I used a working copy. So it's been touched by my hands like twice. Once when I photocopied it 13 years ago and just now. So that's in really good condition. If anyone would like this, you're welcome to have it. Please comment below and just say, okay, so see these three fairies. They are... I don't know if they are supposed to be, but they do remind me and many people of Flora, Fauna and Merriweather from Sleeping Beauty, right? So do you remember that movie? Flora was like the fat pink fairy and she was like the motherly one. Fauna was like a bit of a nerd. Yeah, she was the nerdy one. She was skinny and tall and kind of a little... Maybe not uptight, I don't know. And Merriweather was like the short, plump, she was really short, the blue one. The short, plump, kind of crazy, go weird all over the place one. So tell me which one of these you think your personality is most like. Flora, Fauna, or Merriweather. So if you want the passion, do that and tell me you want the passion. You can just tell me which fairy you are, even if you don't want the passion, that's fine. So I will send it to anyone in the world. Please be 18 or have your parents' permission to give me your address. It's not, I'm not calling it a giveaway. I'm giving away a pattern, but, I'll do a draw if more than one person wants it. Cause I think more than one person will. It's a pretty pattern, right? Yeah. So, okay, there you go. You can have this Flora, Fauna or Merriweather. So let's talk about some haul. Okay. Let's do haul. So first, because this is the least exciting one, don't worry, I'm not turning into a knitting blog, a floss tuber who like spends half the video doing knitting. I'm not doing that. I have one ball of wool here. This is Malabrigo Rios. I'm very unfamiliar with yarn. It's like an overdyed worsted weight, pure merino superwash yarn. I'm just saying all this stuff because people know what this means. I don't know what any of this means. And I think the colour was called English Rose. But it's pink. I just wanted some pink sort of variegated yarn so I could knit myself a pussy hat. I found the pattern for the pussy hat. It's super easy. My knitting skills are very like rudimentary. Really, yeah, I'm not a good knitter. I can do like... The pussy hat's very easy. It's like a ribbed band around the front. And then it's a big long stockinette, which I can do that because it's just knit and purl. And then it's another rib band at the back, and then you fold it in half and sew it on the sides and wear it. And that's about as complex as my knitting skills get. So that's what I'm going to do. This was pretty damn expensive, by the way. I didn't realise wool was so crazy expensive. And when I say expensive, like $25 Australian plus a bit of postage. I don't know if that's expensive. If that's considered expensive by people who know yarn. I don't know, but I thought it was expensive. But yeah, I think it's going to be pretty, and it's going to go nice on my head like that, against the blue hair. You might notice my hair is a lot bluer now. The green fades really fast, so I asked Tim to help me cover it up, and Tim likes the blue, so it ended up mostly blue. That's what happened there. Okay, more haul. I got some needle winders from Jen at Delicious Threads. Look at that, they're so cute! I was obviously in a gay mood when I got these, and all I was thinking was, oh, I need needle winders to put on, Gamer Nouveau. I've been so dying to stitch Gamer Nouveau. Do you ever get, like, the craving to stitch on something? I've been craving full coverage stitching. I don't know why, it's really strange. I need coffee. It's early in the morning, sorry, I need coffee. Oh, look at this. It's an empty spool of Krynek. I have another almost empty spool. I have 3 half spools. That's how much Krynek was in those fairies. Anyway, sorry, I'm all over the place today. So, yeah, I wanted to put these on Gamer Nouveau, even though I already have a Princess Peach and a gigantic red mushroom for Gamer Nouveau. But now I have a little controller. Do you know who that is, guys? That's Shira. She is my hero. I love her. Shira and Tiger Lily. Okay, you know people... I'll talk about Tiger Lily in a second. Let me finish these, then I'll talk about Tiger Lily, then I'll do the rest of... Sorry, I'm all over the place. Okay. Got a game controller. I got a green mushroom, because this one's the one-up mushroom in Extra Life. There's Shira. I love Shira. There's a smiling pile of poop. That's a companion cube from Portal. If you guys haven't played Portal, even if you're not a gamer, it's such a good game. Like, if you think you're not into shooting games and stuff, but you think you might want to play games, play this. It's really good. And a creeper from Minecraft. This is also a good sort of entry game for people to get into. It's sort of a survival, make your own goal, automate everything game. So that's a scary creeper. And my nephew's going to love this one when he sees it. So I'll be able to stick 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, and Alice with the long neck. Because this is... adorable, and it's my favourite part of that Alice in Wonderland book. I love these, the classic illustrations of Alice. So yeah, those 4 will go on Gamer Nouveau probably, and Gamer Nouveau will be just heavy with needle minders. She'll have more needle minders than stitches, because I haven't touched her in so long. Because I was supposed to do her for full coverage on the 5th last month and this month. This month I was really sick on the 5th, so I did no stitching for 2 days. And last month, I think I forgot about full coverage on the 5th, so yeah. Anyway, I really like all of these. I think Delicious Threads is my new favourite needle minder place. Yay, I love them. Okay, I was going to talk about Tiger Lily. So everyone seems to be pretty obsessed with Princess Belle at the moment. And everyone's got their favourite Disney princess. But I just wanted to say that my favourite Disney princess is a Tiger Lily. And she's not a princess that most people talk about or think about or like. And I don't know what... Okay, I think I know why that is. She's not like a main character. There's another girl in that movie, which is Wendy, and Wendy's the main character. Tiger Lily's like incidental. But I think in Peter Pan's life for a long time, Tiger Lily was way more important to him than Wendy was, because he didn't know who Wendy was. So I'm thinking about the Disney movie. I remember the bit where Captain Hook actually kidnaps Tiger Lily. It's pretty dark. He kidnaps Tiger Lily, ties her up on a rock when the tide's coming in, and says to her, where's Peter Pan? Where's Peter Pan? Where's Peter Pan? Tell me where Peter Pan is. And she doesn't. She sits there. There's water coming up like this, and she won't tell him. She's just silent. She won't speak. And the water's coming up, and it's going in her mouth, and she won't tell him. She is so tough and strong and stubborn, and I love her. I think she's amazing. I love Tiger Lily, and those are the qualities that I thought I wanted in myself when I was a kid and I watched Peter Pan. Way more than like, oh, I want to be, I want to meet a prince and I want to sing songs and I want to be friends with all woodland animals. No, I wanted to, I would have died with honour. I don't know, I like to think I would. I don't know. That's why I like Tiger Lily. It's so sad that there's never Tiger Lily things, you know, merch, you know. I wish that I... Okay, there's my needle minders. Cool. What's next for haul? Well, this isn't really haul, but let's talk about it. It's maybe like an upcoming whip. It's my round robin. I got Coral's round robin in the mail. She sent a nice little card. She sent me a little angel that I presume she made. Yes, she did. Like this. It's so pretty. It's so cute, right? And on the back, there's a little charm that says, made with love. You'll never see that. But trust me, it says it. She sent me a cottage garden thread, which I don't have any of. These things are crazy expensive, cottage garden threads. I don't know why. But I mean, they are pretty. They're gorgeous. The colours are so nice. But they're like three times... I think they're like $6 or $7 for this in the shop. And I can get a dinky dye silk for $5.50. Why would I pay $7 for this when I can get a dinky dye silk for $5.50? But I do really like it. It's pretty. It's called Sage. It's number 800. It's a greeny blue colour. And now on to the actual round robin. I love the fabric this is on. It's 28 count cashel, obviously. It's like a really pale lavender, pale purple. You'll never be able to see it, to see the colour properly, I don't think. It's very, very pale purple. I actually think, oh, it might be my eyes. It's not really purple at all. I don't know. So this is going to be some kind of bluebird on a branch. It's really pretty. Don't know if there's a finished picture in here I can show you. Oh, yes, there is. Good. There it is. From a magazine, it's originally charted for Anchor, and Coral has changed the colours to DMC so that we can all stitch it a little more conveniently. Because there are only three people in our round robin, she originally had split it into four because we thought we were having four, and then she, I think it goes this way, and then she split this bottom quadrant into two. So I think Coral did this part, and then Stella did this part, and then I'll be doing this and this. So I need to finish this month. This will be my new start on the 17th. So there we go. That's Coral's round robin. It's pretty, right? It's very pretty. Okay. Put that in there. It's so hard when you make a video. There's just stuff everywhere, and I feel really disorganized, and like everything's precariously stacked around the place, and got the coffee right in front of the camera, and everything's weird. I'm really thirsty. Morning is not a good time to make the videos. I just had to make this video today because today's the 15th of April. I've been meaning to show you Firefly Fairies for a long time, and I needed to talk about my plans for Jessie Marie's birthday sale before it starts, which is today. So here's my video. So I did get some more haul. Just a minute. I need to stand up to even pick it up. Yeah. It's big. Well, each individual thing isn't big, but the pile is big. Ugh. See this? Look at that. This was sent to me from my grandmother in Perth. Whoa! I nearly dropped the whole bunch. She sent me... all of these are issues of Sampler and Antique Needlework Quarterly. Ta-da! Don't know if anyone used to read this magazine. This is my favourite magazine. My mum got this for like the whole time it was out. I think my mum has every issue. This isn't every issue. It goes from issue 13. It misses out about 15, somewhere around the 40s. And then it goes up until volume 17, number 3. No, this is volume 13. Wait a minute. Yeah, so in the beginning, the volume was just a number volume. But by the end, this is volume 17, number 3. So I have no idea how many this is in terms of how many they released. I would love to do a comparison and go through these and figure out which ones I need to get and get them all. I really can't wait to go through these. It's going to take me months to go through and read all of these and decide which things I actually want to stitch. I'm going to have to spend as much time as I would stitching something, just going through these to decide what I want to stitch. So I love these. I'm so excited about this. This is why I'll be making a start next month for my grandma, because I am so excited about these. They're really heavy. I can't believe she paid for postage for these. They're so heavy. She also sent me these ones, which are Fine Lines magazine. I don't suppose anyone's ever heard of this. It's from the Historic Needlework Guild, the American Historic Needlework Guild in Newcastle, Pennsylvania, or originally in Ingomar, Pennsylvania. And Fine Lines, it's actually quite a short magazine, and this is actually a four-part Darlene Osteen sampler that was released in the first four parts of this magazine that I have read. It's really nice, and I'd like to do it one day. So I've got, I don't know, 20 or so issues, not episodes, of this. She also sent me Sampler and Antique Needlework book, and volume 2. I'm a very lucky girl, right? All of this was free. My grandma she doesn't stitch anymore. And she wanted me to have them because I might stitch something from them, and I can't. I love, like, reproduction stuff, so. She sent me a planner that, it's nice, right? I really should use it for planning my stitching. I have one section for stuff I want to talk about in floss tube, one section for tracking what I stitch, and one section for wish list? Don't know. Future starts? I don't know. And she gave me a thing called a notebook of sampler stitches. And yeah, it's like stitch diagrams and nice instructions and so on. So that's really nice. I love this. I already thanked my grandma. I know she doesn't watch my videos. I don't want her to at the moment because I'm going to stitch her a secret something. I'm going over to Perth in September. Perth is, okay, so in Australia, from Canberra to Perth, it's about a 5-hour flight. And, well, actually, there's only one flight a day that goes direct to Perth. And if you don't get on that flight, it's quite expensive too. If you don't get on that flight, you have to go via Sydney or Melbourne. So it's expensive. Getting to Perth is a pain in the butt, and it's expensive. It's like $500 each way for the ticket. So I'll be saving up for Tim and I to go to Perth, because he hasn't met any of my mum's side of the family who lives over there, so that'll be good. Yeah, so when I go to Perth, I'll be thanking her. So I have a new start. I got some haul. This was the haul I got in celebration of 40 years by Wish Helped. And my new start comes from this book. And this book has a number of designs from all the Wish Helped kind of artists, I suppose. There's a little rose by Perman. I'll try not to show you charts, but I'm not too worried about it because I don't worry too much about showing charts, guys, because you're never going to be able to actually stitch from a little flash of a chart. Sunflower by Perman. This is Debbie Mum. It's a sprinkler. It's quite pretty. If you had the right fabric, that would be really pretty. Let's see. Yeah. A funky tree ornament by Mill Hill. This one's going to be kind of tough to show. There you go, Christmas tree. Lots of beads. And then a welcome pumpkin. You are always welcome. Lots of beads on that, lots of bling. This is by Jim Shaw. And then on each page it gives you a little bio of like the artist, which is quite nice. There's a nice bio of Nora Corbett in here. Oh, so there's a Mirabilia in this book, and that's what I started. There's a pussycat. It's by Jim Shaw. It's called Lucky, as you can see from the page there. What do we have next? Oh, a lot of people are going to like this, I think. This is Mill Hill. It's called Christmas Village Shops. I would never stitch this. But it's cute. It is cute. Then there's two pages of gigantic chart. Okay, we've got Mill Hill Midnight Santa. This is cute. I think that's cute. I also would never stitch this, but I think it's cute. Okay, now there's Okay, this is by Styx. It's called Merry Christmas. This, I might stitch. It is cute. And this is the one I started. This is called Red Skies at Night by Mirabilia. God, I love the border on this. I just love it. I love the look of the border. I'm not enjoying stitching it. Let's just say that. Yeah, it's pretty, right? It'll be my first Mira Mermaid. That's a joke, right? Because the mermaid's like 15 stitches high. It is a mermaid. You're a mermaid. It's true. Yeah, so there's a little bio of Nora which was interesting to read because I'll be meeting Norah in a few weeks in Katoomba. Materials, and then obviously chart. Okay. This is Thea Gouverneur Nasturtium. I don't know if I said Gouverneur correctly. That is quite pretty, actually. I would never stitch all that orange, but it does look pretty. It really does. And that's it. Then there's general instructions for cross stitching. And the back cover. Cool, right? This book was like $30. Expensive, but it's more expensive than a normal mirror chart. But I might pass it on when I'm done with the stitching. Anyway, I will show you my start. Now you know. Oops. I'm sorry. Don't vomit. I'm really sorry. So here's my stitch. Okay. Sorry about that. I had to delete videos off my device because it was full. So here's my stitching on Red Skies at Night by Mirabilia. It's really tiny. It's literally only this big. And it goes down to there. It's really tiny. The fabric is Valor by Picture This Plus. It's kind of a greyish green. I don't know. Yeah, I think you're seeing it okay. Might be a little washed out for you. It's pretty. You can see the border. You can see the start of the moon and the flag on the ship. And yeah, I think they're the sails on the ship. So that's all I've done. The border is so pretty. There's a water lilies called Pesto in the border. I love the border. It's really pretty. There are these gigantic size 6, I think, beads that go here. Anyway, I worked on this. This was my birthday start. Happy birthday to me. It was my birthday on the 1st of April. This was my new start. On my birthday, I went to the Canberra Cross Stitches meetup, the North Side meetup, and Jo Vintage Chic Stitcher came and she brought a cake and it was really nice and I started this, it was great. Then I stitched it for the next 2 days and then I put it away. And then I got sick and didn't stitch anything, and then I decided I wanted to finish Firefly Fairy. So this will come up sometime in the next few weeks because I'm going to talk about my plans for Jessie Murray Stitch Along in a second, and this will feature a bit in that, but not too much. Because I'll be mainly focusing in the Stitch Along on things I want to finish. There are four things. I think I might be able to get 4 more finishes this month. Firefly Fairies and 4 more things. I'll tell you about it. Actually, I think I've done all the haul. Yeah, I'm going to tell you about it now because it's time. So Jessie Marie's Stitch Along. I've been planning to do this for a while, but I kept planning it and I didn't know if I was going to finish Firefly Fairies before it started, so I was holding off on telling you my plans because basically I was trying to put Firefly Fairies in every day so I could just say I was doing it so I could get it done, right? So I was trying to jam Firefly Fairies into every day, like, anyway. But now that's finished, I have a lot more flexibility. I've got a few other things to jam into it. I have a few things that are very close to finishing that I should be able to finish this month. So the 15th, the stitch along starts on the 15th, and it says to stitch on your oldest or first whip. So my oldest whip, I'm back. I need a new phone holder thing because the phone just flipped out of the tripod holder again, and that's what happened last time I was filming too, and it's annoying me. Okay, so this is my oldest whip. This is called Dream a Dream, and it's a Janlin kit published in 1987. I started this in... So I mistakenly said in an earlier video, I think it was my whips video, I said I started it in 1989. And that's not correct. The more I thought about it, the more I realized that can't be true. So I spoke to my mom and we figured out that I must have started it in 1991 or 2. So I would have been 8 or 9 years old when I started it, which means it's like 28 years old. Yeah, 25 years, sorry. I can't add. Yeah, I was 8 or 9 years old and that was 25 years ago. So I started this 25 years ago and I'm going to finish it. I'll take it off the Q-snap. I'm going to finish it tomorrow, I think, because I'm nearly done. It's amazing how quick. There's not a lot of work in that. This is stitched up really quickly since I picked it up yesterday. So here is where I'm up to, and it is full of mistakes. It's funny, because I started this when I was a kid. It's funny seeing how my stitches in some parts are really, like, the threads all twisted and I pulled too hard, and there are counting mistakes. Like, you can see this verse, I only discovered this yesterday, this verse is too far over this way, it doesn't line up with these verses. And so I stitched these three animals yesterday underneath this verse, so they're too far this way. Then I stitched this verse counting from the puppy, and that was too far this way, so this verse didn't line up there. So I've just fudged it, I just moved this verse over this way, and I'll stitch the next verse here in the correct place, and then hopefully we'll be all evened up. I don't want to unstitch all these animals and this verse and this ship. But yeah, I have two more verses to go. I've almost finished this verse. Since I picked it up, I actually started on Thursday night after I finished Firefly Fairies. Yesterday, Good Friday, public holiday, I stitched this whole verse and those three animals. So I think I'll be stitching this on the 15th for my oldest whip, and I'll probably be able to do the second last verse pretty easily. I might be able to finish it tomorrow. We'll see. Today. The 15th is today. We'll see. But it's very close to finishing, guys. The fabric is stained. I knew I had counting errors in this. So much so, I was so worried about the stained fabric and the state of it that I actually even went out and bought half a meter of new aider to restart it if I needed to. But it turns out I don't need to. I'm happy enough with what I have. So there we go. Dream a dream. I will be stitching that on the 15th. The 16th is JMDS, which stands for Jessie Marie Does Stuff, or Jessie Marie and Danny Sites. So you're supposed to stitch on something starting with one of those letters. So I will be stitching on D, Dream a Dream. Shalkara, Dream a Dream. If I finish that, I will move to something beginning with S, which is this. This is Schwalm White Work by Deborah Love. And I'm currently up to here. So this is also nearly finished. I reckon there's 10 hours of work left in that. So yeah, I just got really stuck on doing these eyelets. Up here. These, oh, what are they? They're not eyelets. Yeah, they are. Whatever they are, these stitches here, they're just really boring and repetitive. So I'll be working on this if I finish Dream a Dream for S. Enabled, stitch on something you were enabled to start. Okay, the 17th. The first thing I have to do is start Coral's Round Robin, which is the bird I showed you before. So I have to start that on the 17th. Ta-da! Something I was unable to start was this. I wasn't unable to start this particular one. I have never seen anyone stitch this. I haven't seen any pictures online. But I saw the book. I saw a million people stitching Mirabilias. I knew I wanted to start a Mirabilia. I knew I wanted to wait until I finished Firefly Fairies until I started a mirror. And I decided I wanted to start something a little bit smaller. So I started this. So I'll be stitching on this on the 17th for Enabled. Sorry, I knocked you over with a Q-snap. Today is just a disastrous day. Seriously. Where's my book? Okay. The 18th, favourite colours, maroon, red, orange, or purple. I don't think I have anything with maroon, orange. I just don't stitch those colours really, it's strange. So this has purple in it, Red Skies at Night. So I'll work on the border of Red Skies at Night and stitch a bunch of purple. That's good. I like Red Skies at Night. 19th, stitch on something with an animal in it. I think by that time I'll be finished with Dream a Dream. Dream a Dream has lots of animals in it, but I think it'll be finished, so I will probably stitch on Coral's Round Robin, which is this bird of some description. And because this has to be done by the end of the month, because it will get posted on the 1st of May. The 20th, Miss Congeniality, stitch on something pretty. I think that Coral's Round Robin is very pretty, so if it's not finished, I will stitch on that. And I also think that the Schwalm White Work flowers are very pretty. So if I finish Coral's Round Robin, I will work on the Schwalm White Work. 21, stitch on something difficult for Taurus or Diamond. Oh, So something difficult. If I haven't finished the Schwarm, I will do that. Not that I find the Schwarm difficult, but these eyelids, they kill me. So, but what I also thought I'll do for something difficult is... Remember this? This is Celtic Sampler Wallace. This enormous square up here is what I decided I was going to tackle next, and it is solid queen stitches. Solid queen stitches. I don't find queen stitches difficult per se. I find it difficult to do more than three because they're boring. They look pretty. This one is solid queen stitches. It looks amazing, right? Looks awesome. This one is solid queen stitches, except there are gaps for some metallics. This gigantic thing is solid queen stitches. So is this gigantic thing. So is one of those two small things and that thing, I think. I hate queen stitches. So yeah, I'll get started on some of those queen stitches because that is going to try my patience. Diamond is also my birthstone because I was born April. April 1st, April Fool's Day. I ain't kidding. 22nd, close to 30, stitch on something that is almost finished. So I have a lot of things that are almost finished. The schwarm, if it's not finished, will be almost finished. Coral's Round Robin, if it isn't finished, will be almost finished. Another thing I have that's almost, actually this isn't close to finished, so maybe I shouldn't. But this is my closest thing to finished after those two, which is Paddington Bear in Sydney by Payment of Copenhagen. If you haven't watched my channel for a long time, this is a set of four patterns. There's Paddington in London, New York, and Paris that I've already done. This is the last one in the set. This is Sydney, and this will be for my nephew Lachlan. He's 7 years old, so he will be getting all four of these. This is where I'm up to. Not really almost finished, but it's actually less than half done. But I think it's the closest thing to finish because there's not a lot of work left in this. So that's what I'll be stitching on that day. So, by the way, this is for Lachlan. He's 7. The Firefly Fairies are for my niece, Charlie. She is 5. And her twin brother, Benjamin, will be getting Dream a Dream. So there's something for each of the kids. When I first started this in 1992, it was going to be for my little brother. So I changed this line to say, Jamie can catch loads. And obviously, before I finish this, I'll change this line to say, Ben can capture loads. He saw this and he went like crazy over it. He loves it. He's really into animals, especially puppies, and he just loves it. Okay. On the 23rd, you have to stitch something to do with the number 29. And I think I will do, if I don't kill myself, 29 queen stitches up here. And then when I finish 29 queen stitches, I won't do another one on that day, at least, and I'll just work more on this because... who can be bothered with queen stitches? I'm just so over them. It's actually destroying my love for that project. I'm so over queen stitches. It's because they're tiny and it's on 40 count fabric and it's hard to fit them in. And it takes so long to do one queen stitch. It takes me 2.5 minutes to do one queen stitch. Ugh, it's crazy. I'm a slow stitcher, but that's ridiculous. My desk is a mess. Because I stitch at my desk, so there's all these threads hanging down for Dream a Dream. There are a bunch of colours in Dream a Dream. Okay, I'm really off track today. I can't concentrate on anything. Bookish. The 24th, stitch something for a book or a story or make up a story about your current whip. So I was trying to think of a story to come up with for my Firefly Fairies because I was trying to jam Firefly Fairies in every day of this cell. But I don't need you now. So something that comes from a book or story is obviously Paddington Bear. Because Paddington Bear is a story character. So I will work on Paddington. Oops. The 25th is Jessie Marie's birthday. Have a new start, work on your most recent start, or work on something with a birthday theme. So my most recent start will be this. If it's not finished. Or I could have a new start, which might be this. Actually, I think I might do that. That'll be really good. Because I'd like to have this stitched before May, because May it does start to get cold. The 25th is also, it's Anzac Day here in Australia, so it's a public holiday. So yeah, I might even knock this out that day. Maybe I'm being optimistic. From memory, knitting doesn't take that long. So, we'll see. Oh, guys, is this big enough to do a pussy hat, a beanie? Anyone who knows wool, can you tell me? I'm not going to be one of those people who shows their knitting constantly. I'll show you this when it's done, but I'm not planning on knitting other things. Although Tim did say, oh, my grandma used to knit me socks every year. And I said, you want me to knit you socks? Like that. Like, you really think that's going to happen? He's like, yeah, I do. I'm like, I think socks are hard, right? I'm not going to be a knitting tuber. I'm not. Sorry. Okay. Yeah. And if I get bored of the knitting, I'll just go to my birthday start because it's birthday themed. I'll stitch more on Red Skies at night. Okay. And the last day of the stitch along is family. Something related to my family. Well, that's easy. I can stitch on Dream a Dream, which is actually almost probably done by then. I can stitch on Paddington, which will probably be, if I've stitched on it for 3 days this stitch along, it'll probably be getting close to done. I also have a whip that I could pull out that I'm doing for my mother or my father. I have whips for both of them. My dad, I'm doing a Teresa Wensler. My mom, I'm doing like a traditional sewing chest with like a sailor and mermaids and stuff. So yeah, those are my plans for the stitch along. I'm exhausted now. This has been a long video and it has to be in a few parts because my camera kept falling off and I ran out of space on my phone and yeah, God, I'm exhausted. Okay, I'm gonna go. I'm gonna get this video off my phone. I'm gonna edit it. I think I'm spending today with my mom. I might be going to her house and looking through all her stitching stuff because she has a lot, and she wants me to help her decide what she doesn't want and sell some stuff on eBay. She said I can have the money. She said because I'll probably know what's out of print and what's desirable these days, so she might sell some stuff and she'll probably give some stuff to me because she's a nice mummy. And we might be starting And a Forest Grew today because she wants to do a stitch along. A few years ago, like 10 years ago, I did a stitch along. When I had a blog, I did a stitch along with a friend called Nikki and we did Takata 2 by The Drawn Thread. I'll put in a picture of my finish. We did this as a stitch along where every Tuesday, we call it Takata Tuesday, we would do two motifs on Takata 2. And it took like an hour every Tuesday and we did that and it was a really great way to keep each other on track. And we shared our progress together and it was a really good way to finish something. It was nice. So Mum and I decided we might do And a Forest Group by Rosewood Manor. And we might start it and do it similarly. So one day a week we'll each pick two little trees or animal motifs and stitch that up. So we might start that today because Mum has apparently like bolts with meters and meters of fabric. So I'll cut some fabric and start that. That'll be nice. Put it on a scroll frame or a key snap. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I don't need a new start. I'm currently at 25 starts, which is the lowest number of starts I've had in years. If I finish four things by the end of the month, the four things are Paddington Bear, Dream a Dream, Schwarm, White Work, and Coral's Round Robin. Four things. That'll be five finishes in 1 month, and I'll be down to 21 whips. But if I start End of Forest Grew, it'll be 22. And I might be starting Coffee Quaker because I realised you can get the pattern in PDF form, which will be 23. Or maybe I won't start those things. I don't know. I have no discipline. Let's not talk about mania because I'm still undecided. I might just do one mania start. I did actually, in this book, write down plans for 31 starts. Yeah. I have no discipline. I would love to do that, but I'm not. I don't know. I might. We'll think about it. Okay, but I'll talk to you before mania. Guys, I'm done. I hope you have a great stitchy week or 2 weeks or month until I see you next. And